story was just kind of impromptu. I was inspired by one of Benji's stories, and I just got up here and rattled off this funny story. The more often I tell this story, the more details I remember, which apparently make it funnier. So, here we go. 1999, year of the 17-year locust. Now, if you guys remember the plague that came through here last summer, that's what I'm talking about. The noise was incredible. June 4th, my 19th birthday, Rigi County, West Virginia, population 11,000 for the entire county. North Bend State Park is where it was in Ritchie County, West Virginia. And that would be the location of what would later go down in history as the great stream littering of the North Fork of the Hughes River. So I was ready to party, along with my first husband and our good friend Liz, who came from a good Syrian Orthodox family. She was just religious enough to know that God couldn't possibly be mad at her for anything her parents didn't find out about. So we reserved a private camp spot in the rustic campground down at North Bend State Park so that we could party all weekend, drinking and smoking pot. So we set up our camp spot. The campground is nestled in between the Hughes River. Behind the campground, the campsite is a long access road that houses the road that goes through the park. And the campground was completely rustic, no electricity or bathrooms or anything. But we had everything we needed for a good party. We had a fire ring, a trash can, and a picnic table. Yeah, woo! Picnic tables. So we set up our campsite, quickly got our four-person pop-up tent set up, got our camp chairs set up around the fire ring, started a roaring fire that it was way too hot for, started drinking beer that we were all too young for, and started smoking the pot that we were in just the right mood for. So shortly after we got settled in, another carload of partiers came thumping in unexpectedly. So of course we had to greet them and say hello, and we communicated with each other and sniffed out each other's party styles. Oh, perfect! We decided to meet up after dark for smoking the blunt of the century. So we were waiting for it to get dark. We were personally sitting at our own campsite waiting, being pretty amused at them trying to set up their campsite while stoned. And a ranger came down and asked them to turn down their music. It was uneventful. They turned down their music. Around 10 o'clock, we wandered over to their campsite. It took a while to get the blunt of the century going because nobody actually knew how to roll a blunt. But we got it going. And by 11 o'clock, we were sitting there having a good time, sitting at their picnic table, which was up against the hill, talking, laughing, sharing stories of living in the South, drinking beer. Our new friend, Steve, was telling a story. He was heavily into the story about truck fishing on the Ohio River. He was talking loud and fast when we noticed a flashlight at the top of the hill. And those of us who were facing the hill were like, our eyes got wide. And then the flashlight started making its way down the hill. And we started going. But Steve, holding his blunt, was having a good time telling this story, and he just did not stop or notice our motions of begging him to stop. And then the ranger was standing next to Steve. And Steve stopped his story long enough to take a big toke of his blunt and pass it to the right. The ranger, with his flashlight in our faces, "Huh, what's this? Can I hit it?" back to our campsite. Our IDs were collected, and we were told to not come out of our tent until the ranger came back. So during this long time, we realized that we still had pot with us, because we had only taken over about half of what we had. We couldn't throw it in the river, because we still wanted to smoke it later. So we had to do something with it, though, because we didn't want it to be found. So we decided, I, being the birthday girl, would put the pot in an empty Pepsi can, walk it to the trash can at our campsite, because nobody could be mad at me for leaving my tent to throw something away, right? And then we would hide it there until we could safely retrieve it. So I unzipped the tent, crawled out, made the 6-mile trek to the trash can, lifted the 300-pound lid, put the pot in, closed the lid, and made the 6-mile trek back to the tent, crawled in, and huddled and waited with my friends. 15 hours later, we didn't need to look outside the tent window to know that a cop car was pulling down the lane, followed by another cop car, followed by another cop car. Well, the cops all descended on the other campsite first, and so we all tried really hard to listen in on the conversations that were going on next door to us. And it went something like this. Search your car! To finish their 60 years worth of paperwork, the canine cop decided to wait next to the trash can with pot in it. Well, we all stopped breathing when we saw this happening, and then our hearts leapt into our throats when we heard the dog going, and the cop took the lid off the trash can with ease. He poked around, shone his flashlight in, put the lid back on the trash can, and told his dumb dog to shut the hell up. We promptly began breathing again. 15 hours later, Officer Mean Mustache, not the ranger, Officer Mean Mustache came and summoned us, out of our tents, motioned for us to sit in our low camp chairs next to the fire, stirred up the embers in the fire so that they were nice and glowing, put his boot on the fire ring, leaned in nice and close so that his face was glowing, and he said, "Now, I'm gonna give you kids 2 choices. We can do this the easy way, or we can do this the hard way. Were you kids smoking pot?" "Oh, yes, officer, we're so sorry." "All right. Well, seeing how this is your first offense, you can either
get a ticket for stream littering, or I can bust you for smoking pot!
Oh, I'll take the stream littering! Thank you, officer! You're the most omniscient police officer ever! Not that I've had any experience with other police officers, but I want to kiss your feet! So, that was great. We got off with stream littering, everybody! Yay for us, right? We got to the top of the hill, started checking out. Ranger at the top said, "Did you hear about the big bust?" "Oh, what? Big bust? What are you talking about?" Oh, then he proceeded to tell the story of the big bust from the ranger's perspective. "Oh, great story. You know what? Thank you so much for protecting us from those crazy potheads." Then the next Monday, we found that street littering in the state of West Virginia imposed a minimum fine of $500 and up to 90 days in jail. Well, I couldn't afford $500 or 90 days in jail. I also couldn't afford an attorney. So really, the only thing I could do was show up in court all by my lonesome and try to get it reduced. I had nothing to lose. On the court date, I sat nervously, waiting for the magistrate, while Officer Mean Mustache shuffled through his papers. Now, the Teresa magistrate, she walked in her pink fuzzy turtleneck sweater. She said, "Well now, tell me what happened." Officer Mean Mustache shuffled his papers around and said, "I was called to the scene of the crime where I found cams surrounding the fire ring and leading down to the stream." During this time, in court, this is what they do in court, by the way. If you want to talk in court, you raise your hand. "Excuse me, can I say something?" "Oh, yeah, honey, you go on ahead." "I was a stream litter and I was smoking pot. I don't want to die in prison." This. So she called the officer to the bench. There was some grunting and grumbling and nodding. And then she said, "Well, tell you what. Now, if you can just do 8 hours of community service cleaning up that river where you were supposedly string littering, I will just go ahead and drop those charges and definitely get rid of the fine for you, too." "Oh my God, Magistrate Teresa, you're the most ambitious and bad trade I've ever known. Not that I've had any in runs with magistrates, but please let me kiss your feet." So on the day of community service, I show up, report to the supervising ranger. We get in the truck, we start heading up to the top of the hill where I'm going to start cleaning up the river that I apparently stream littered. On the way up, the ranger says, "Boy, I sure am sorry about what happened that night. Now, my ranger, he was new and he just didn't know what to do, so he called the cops. You were just trying to have a good time." "I know, and it was my birthday too." "Oh, honey, I'm so sorry." And she looked at me with pity as I got out of the car with the truck with my two trash bags to head down to the lodge cleaning up the river. "You just clean up what you can now, okay? Don't worry about anything too big." So it took about two hours heading down the hill, cleaning up the river. Filled up the two trash bags, although there really wasn't much trash. I did manage to pull a tire out of the river, which I'm pretty proud of. And so I got to the bottom of the hill and I reported back to the lodge after 2 hours of my 8 hours of community service. And Teresa just looked at, or the ranger just looked at me like, "Oh, now what are we gonna do?" "Well, tell you what, honey, why don't you just take your time, clean up the hill behind the lodge?" So I I took my time, cleaned up the hill by the lodge, painstakingly, might I add, picking up two mint wrappers and an empty pack of cigarettes, slaving away. And then after about an hour, I reported back to the ranger. Well, now what are we going to do? You've got at least 4 more hours. Tell you what. See that hill, that trail across the way? You mean the one that's maintained by the Boy Scouts of America? Yeah. You just go on ahead and find something to do on that trail. Entertain yourself. By myself? Onto the trail. Pristine, by the way. Boy Scouts of America are really good at picking up trash on the trails. Wandered my way through, found myself a nice view of the Hughes River, sat myself down on a log, pulled out my emergency joint. I keep one on me at all times. Not anymore, but used to keep one on me at all times. Pulled out my emergency joint and lit up. Finally, a proper burn down for my birthday. Happy birthday to me. Epilogue to the story. I ended up working with one of the guys from the campsite next to me later in that year, and we were comparing stories of what had happened to us that night. I was really proud of myself for dodging that $500 street littering fine and only getting away with community service. And I was feeling really badly for him when he told me he just went ahead and paid his fine for smoking pot. Until he told me how much his fine was for smoking pot. $35. Epilogue to the epilogue. In the spring, they decided that they were going to make a lake for swimming and fishing out of the Hughes River, and so they dammed it up. But it was a particularly rainy spring, and by June, the levee broke, and the Hughes River flooded out the entire campground that we stayed at, taking away the opportunity for any young partiers to ever litter the stream again. So the moral of the story is, if you're given the choice between throwing your trash down and dumping it in the river and smoking pot, always go green.
Give it up, give it up!